Delisa is finally home from the hospital. She was diagnosed with postpartum preeclampsia. We were really scared that she was either gonna have a stroke, a heart attack. So she was in the hospital about a week before she was discharged. So at this point, her blood pressure is stabilized, but at any point in time, it could spike. So the important thing for her to do is to just stay calm and just try to relax.
Oh! It's Get Dion!
Out! Oh my
Get
God!
Get out of here! What are you doing here?
Good to see you.
Hurt my eardrum.
No,
oh my
not.
God!
Just gonna shut up.
Hi. I can't believe you're here. This is so crazy.
Oh my God.
Hi, Mom.
Oh, hi. Look at Uncle Keon.
We heard a knock on the door, and there was Keon, my baby boy, home from the military. I haven't seen him in a year.
You didn't tell me you was coming.
Yeah. Keon's back.
Oh, my goodness.
Did you really cry when he came through the door?
I did.
You cried?
I did.
Really?
I really did.
You know?
He's jealous.
He's not jealous.
I'm not jealous.
No. Look, you get to see the baby Tessa. Yeah. Come here, dude.
Yeah, came.
You gotta wash your hands. Go wash your hands.
Yeah, right? Go ahead.
Get to go back.
I've been in the military for 2 years already, and I don't really get that much time to talk to everybody in the family, but I do keep in contact with my mom. And once I heard my sister finally did have the baby, I knew that I had to come immediately. So I'm here for about a week.
Well, this is great. He can go to dinner with you guys.
Yeah, I'm like, I didn't really plan on, it was only for two people.
Wow.
I made the reservation for two.
Wow.
I'm not gonna call and like change it. Keon will understand. Like, he can spend time with you and Tessa and the girls.
Okay. Wow, boy, he looked like he got taller, right?
Every time.
Yes, every what are you time. Like 6'7"?
You guys are just getting shorter.
It was good seeing Keon, but it was kind of bad timing because Trevor had this dinner for me and I want to spend time with my son as well. So everything is just hectic. But it seemed really important to Trevor that it was just me, him tonight. So I just told myself, we can hang out later. You here for a while.
What do you wear?
I don't know. What color you want to wear?
Did you know that they wear matching color, like matching outfits?
I didn't know that.
I knew that Trevor and my mom was close. When I was 11 or 12, Trevor would come around just to hang out with me and my mom. But they ain't never been as close as they are now. Like, dinner dates? Matching clothes? What is going on?
They're having a little moment in there, I guess.
A black top, maybe. How's that?
That's fine.
They are really something else.
I'm surprised she wasn't the one to be like, no, he needs to come. Because she seems to, like, love her boys.
I thought they would have included me since it's my first day back.
Hello.
I have no problem spending time with you, so.
Thank you. I know, Grandma and Daddy's weird.
Lisa's giving me a hard time about this dinner, but it's because I didn't tell her what it's about.
I didn't want any type of added stress. I don't want Mom to go. Like, I really don't. But after the scare that we just had with Delisa being so sick after giving birth, we will see y'all later. Love you. I know it's time to have this conversation with her and let her know that it's time that she moves out. Like, I just wanted some time just with you. It's been a crazy few weeks in the house with Tessa being born, Delisa being in the hospital, and Mom really stepping up to help me out. So I want to do something really nice for her. What we got here?
Grits.
Yes, please. Can I have just the creamy grits? You getting grits?
I'm getting grits. I'm gonna try
them. Are you gonna start with your grits? That's really good.
They're really good.
I told you you were gonna like it.
I do want to thank Mom for everything that she's done. She's been unbelievable helping me while Delisa's been in the hospital. But there's another reason why I'm asking her to dinner tonight, and that is to tell her that she needs to find her own place.
But Mom, in all seriousness, I just wanted to thank you for all your help the last month with everything going on with Delisa, the girls, the baby, you know, like, it was a lot on me. You really stepped up and helped me out because I needed it.
Thank you.
No, thank you.
Thank you.
Seriously. So, I also asked you to come here because I think it was time we talked. With everything going on with Lisa and, you know, her health.
Well, her health is just like my health. And I told her that before too, because it's actually hereditary.
I'm not a doctor. Like, I don't know the whole science behind, like, what causes preeclampsia. So I'm just like, all right, well, you know, like, I'm worried about her being anxious. I'm worried about her being stressed. Like, the kids are stressful. She's not sleeping. And my thing is, like, what's going to be, like, best for Delisa and her health moving forward? And, you know, she's asked me time and time again, you know, when's mom leaving?
Here we go.
When's mom leaving?
I knew it was coming.
Yeah, and I've, like, constantly pushed it off or, like, not said anything or been like, yeah, I'll talk to her. You know, like, I kick the can down the road a little bit longer. But I think, like, it's time for you to find a place. You already know. I don't want you to have to go.
I'm because Trevor invited me to come down here. I gave up everything to come down here. My apartment, my job, my furniture, I mean, even my friends. I have no friends down here in Atlanta. I gave everything to come down here. So you're gonna take me out to eat? You didn't have to take me out to eat. That's like feeding the pig and then slaughtering it afterwards and then eating it.
Till this day, till this conversation right now, I don't want you to have to go. You know, but like, I'm petrified. Like, I'm really scared that something's gonna happen to my wife.
When I'm asked to come down here, I lost everything to come down here.
I know. Relax.
You know what?
I get it. Wait, what? Where are you going? Where are you going?
I'm out.
Where's she going? I'm so embarrassed. She's gonna just leave me here. Don't call her behind.
I was hopeful that we could at least have the conversation and walk away from it in some type of good space. Like, I can't even stress enough how disappointed I am in her.
So she's not gonna pick up the goddamn phone. She's leave me here and not pick up, and now I gotta catch an Uber.